Party Rock is in the house tonight. Everybody just have a good time.
Yeah.
And we gon' make you lose your mind.
Woo.
Everybody just have a good time.
Clap.
Party Rock is in the house tonight.
Oh.
Everybody just have a good time.
I can feel it.
And hey. We gon' make you lose.
Brothers Dick and Mac McDonald launched their first restaurant specializing in barbecue food in California in 1940, McDonald's Barbecue. After noticing that 80% of their revenue came primarily from burgers, in 1948, the brothers temporarily closed down for 3 months to develop a new plan and configuration centered on the streamlining of burger assembly, the speedy service system.
The workforce was divided and arranged into a predefined and highly synchronized teamwork pattern. McDonald's also introduced an open plan kitchen where food was prepared beforehand in order to meet the anticipated demand, and bar stools at the counter allowing customers to observe the cooking, emphasizing the image of quality. They incorporated stainless steel, easy to clean surfaces, and the frequent public cleaning promoted the image of cleanliness. At the time, fast food restaurants would take orders from customers in their cars and deliver food to them in the parking lots, termed car hops. McDonald's were the first to depart from the car hop concept when they introduced indoor seating in Colorado in 1962. Moreover, they replaced traditional cutlery with paper cups and plates, increasing the pace of operations and eliminating the operation of washing up. McDonald's introduced a 30-second serving cycle to help maintain the customer's desire to queue.
McDonald's have innovated several aspects of their business to attract more customers. In 1975, McDonald's introduced their first drive-thru in Arizona. To attract more children, McDonald's introduced the Happy Meal in 1979 and Play Place in 1987. Through exploring areas for expansion beyond opening more stores, McDonald's have created opportunities for innovation.
I'm loving it. Is this the place to eat? Since I don't cook, I'll just rock to the beat. I'm loving it. At the end of the day, to relieve the stress, we add a little play. I'm loving it. Sometimes we have mishaps. You just overcome and adapt to setbacks. I'm loving it. You know you're my world. How could I mind love taps from my girl?
Most of us could build a better hamburger than McDonald's. But few, if any of us, could build a better system for delivering these hamburgers than McDonald's. The strategic capability of McDonald's is their ability to coordinate production, logistics, and distribution by using complementary assets along the value chain. Moreover, McDonald's has been very successful at workflow and quality control associated with these operations. To ensure high standards, the firm uses external auditors to verify the compliance with ISO 22000 and HACCP standards. As a system, these capabilities are hard to imitate and allow for delivering standardized products and services, improving productivity, reducing cycle times, and lowering costs. If the patties pass, they are packaged and delivered to a distribution center and sent to McDonald's across the nation. McDonald's success in foreign markets has been built on the ability to efficiently transfer knowledge to franchisees about operating the McDonald's system. The Hamburger University has been instrumental in this process, with more than 80,000 managers graduating since 1961. McDonald's goes beyond teaching their employees. They also instruct suppliers on how to be more efficient and effective. Also, rapid adaptation to foreign market preferences is an important capability for global success. McDonald's have been quick to introduce new technologies to improve speed and efficiency. The use of mobile point-of-sales devices and self-service kiosks shorten queue times and reduce labor costs. McDonald's have also introduced free Wi-Fi to most of their restaurants and are pioneering media downloading kiosks. McDonald's extensive use of technology also extends to their information systems to manage supplies and infrastructure. For greater cost efficiency and energy management, McDonald's is using Echelon Powerline networking technology to provide communication and data exchange between kitchen equipment. McDonald's have an innovation center where new products, restaurant designs, and kitchen equipment can be explored in a risk-free, cost-effective environment so that only the best innovations are introduced. This top-down approach to innovation is important as the scale of McDonald's would see magnified problems in untested services. At the regional level, franchises, suppliers, and customers help develop the product concepts. Therefore, an element of bottom-up innovation is also associated with McDonald's. Franchisees are often a valuable source of idea generation. McDonald's have created an environment with the correct mix of organizational structure and individual autonomy to encourage successful innovation. Suppliers of McDonald's are unique in that they often cooperate in order to improve the quality of existing products through sharing knowledge and innovative ideas. McDonald's can therefore benefit from this rare interaction by increasing the sources of potential innovation. Within McDonald's, the supply chain and menu management teams do not collaborate. This makes the menus customer-driven and not supply-driven. McDonald's also have an innovation council and store technology board, which determine strategic goals in terms of innovation and technology to ensure that customer demands are satisfied. The strength of the alignment between the company, its franchisees, and suppliers has been the key to McDonald's success. McDonald's face problems of changing consumer preference, becoming more health conscious, placing a premium on freshness and taste. Mass production of fresh foods would therefore be more challenging. McDonald's have to consider the availability of goods before they introduce a product. For example, they could not introduce shrimp salad globally as levels of shrimp were not sustainable. Innovation through McDonald's could leak out of various sources, such as suppliers and franchisees. Also, the increasing number of stores would make it difficult to innovate in areas of management. McDonald's have an opportunity to improve its public relations and cost efficiency through innovative use of technology to reduce its environmental footprint. This would first occur in their mature, saturated markets and could include installing solar panels to using innovative store designs to be more environmentally friendly. McDonald's can bring innovative ideas to existing markets in order to increase revenues, for example bringing McDonald's Cafe or delivery into the UK market. Also using their existing know-how and infrastructure, McDonald's could launch a new fast food brand specialising in other areas.
Checkered. Luma na yan.
Sombrero pa.
Dati na yan.
Kape-kape pa.
Parang tayo lang dati yan.
Mga padre.
Himala. Nag-blowout si Kulut.
Sa McDonald's Everyday McSavers, ang Coke McFloat, 25 pesos lang.
Uy, ang daming bagong apps ngayon ah.
Kunti na lang memory ko eh. Sino ka na nga?
Tomato McGrand. I'm loving it. Debut.
ね、そっち行ってもいいかな?
え? Teriyaki loves chicken fileo. この夏だけの Teriyaki chicken fileo. I'm loving it.
Big Mac.
Combo or sandwich?
Sandwich.
Combo.
كله إلا الكومبو اللي بتحبه
كومبو ماكدونالدز يشبعك من غير ما يدفعك.
أنا بحبه.
مستر हमने सुना है कि यहाँ हमारे जमाने के दामों में बहुत सारी चीजें मिल रही है, क्या ये बात सही है?
मैकडॉनल्ड्स का हैप्पी प्राइस मेन्यू अब सिर्फ 20 रुपए में, पैसा वसूल।
आई एम लविंग इट।